if you're looking at thinking of living in a city, it's a deeply disenfranchising or dehumanizing experience, right? You're one person among millions, especially in the kind of Indian cities that we have. And then when you move around in this kind of chaotic city, how do you get a sense of ownership and how do you know your community? A commons is basically a community resource. But if you think of commons from the perspective of not official management, but who uses it and who can have some say in the management, then you can have urban commons of various kinds.
ನಾನು ಗ್ರಾಮೀಣ ಪ್ರದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ಹುಟ್ಟಿ ಬಂದವನಿಂದ ನಮ್ಮೂರಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಒಂದು ಕೆರೆ ಇದೆ ಸಂಜೆ ಟೈಮಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಮಕ್ಕಳಾದಾಗ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆಟ ಆಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ವು ಅಪ್ಪ ಅಮ್ಮ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬೈದಾಗ ಮನೆಗಳಿಗೆ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ವಿ ನಾವು
ಮ್ಯಾಪ್ಸಾಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಟ್ರಸ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಲುಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೇಕ್ ಎಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಎಸ್ ಅನದರ್ ತ್ರೀ ಲೇಕ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಟು 200 ಏಕರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೇಕ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ವಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಆನ್ ಕೈಕೊಂಡ್ರಹಳ್ಳಿ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಯಲ್ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲೇಕ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಡಿಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ from 2008 onwards to about 2010 and 11 and then you know water started coming in and it started looking like a lake
per barsa kudu ha chinadu kerdu alla nariya kudu nina 30 varshamanda avanga vela pannikirudha naan vandu 10 varsha aadu இங்கே 3 வருஷமாக இங்கே வேலை செய்யுது மீன் பிடிக்கிறது
ஸோ அரவுண்ட் ட்வைஸ் அ வீக் ஃபார் த லாஸ்ட் 5 இயர்ஸ் ஐ பீன் ரன்னிங் இட்ஸ் அபவுட் அ 1.9 கிலோமீட்டர் லூப் ஸோ வி டூ ஆர் ஸ்பீட் ஒர்க் அவுட்ஸ் டெம்போ ரன்ஸ்
வென் யூ லுக் அட் அன் அர்பன் common in the midst of an affluent area. Normally what tends to happen, the middle class is very good at sort of using these kind of spaces for their recreation, for their professional advancement and things like that. Whereas most of the people who are dependent on commons for their livelihoods find it difficult to engage, probably because that's how the narrative is set. We are saying we're all stakeholders, all of us who live around here. We want people to take from the lake, but we also want all of us to give back to the lake.
Lakes like Kaikondoli Lake and a number of other lakes are trying to work with the communities around them to see how they can help grazing communities, for instance, or fishing groups.
சாயங்காலம் 6 மணிக்கு 6-7 மணிக்கு வள விடுறது 5 மணிக்கு எடுக்கிறது காலையில் 5 மணிக்கு இப்போ பிடிக்கிறோம் 50 கிலோ 60 கிலோ இப்போ ஏதோ சுமாராக கிட்டுது கூலி ஏதோ செஞ்சால் மட்டும் எவ்வளோ கஷ்டப்படுறோமா அவ்வளோ கஷ்டப்படா காட்டி ஏதோ கூலி கிட்டுறதில்ல கஷ்டப்பட்டாக்கா கூலி கிட்டுறது இல்லைன்னா இல்லை
வாரக்கா ஒரு 4 சதி 3 சதி பத்தே மேடம் எல்லாம் உள் கட் மாடிக்கொண்டு எத்துக்கொண்டு ஒத்தா இருத்தீவி ಕೆರೆ ಒಳಗಡೆ ನಮ್ಮದು ಯಾವ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಹುಲ್ಲು ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ಯಾರು ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ
ಇವಾಗ ಕರಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬಿಟ್ಟಾಕ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಮೇಯ್ತದೆ ಇನ್ನು ಬೇರೆ ಕರೆಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಯಾವುದು ಮೇಯ್ದಲ್ಲ ಈ ಕರೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟಾಕ ಏನು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗೋದಕ್ಕೆ ನನಗೆ ಇದ್ದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಯಿತು ಎಲ್ಲ ಚುಟ್ಟಿಮುತ್ತ ಅಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಯಿತು ಈ ಕರೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟಮೇಲೆ ನೀವು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೇ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಹಸುವಲ್ಲ
ಯುನೋ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಅನ್ ಅಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್ ಅಟ್ ಕೇಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೊ ಪೊಲ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್ ಲೇಕ್ ದಿ ಆಟೋಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಅಸಂಪ್ಷನ್ ವುಡ್ ಬಿ that the people who have been here before have spoiled the lake, we have come in to save the lake. And now I think they're very aware of the fact that there were villages around this place that have, they were the ones who created the lake and for centuries have been protecting it, and it's urban development because of apartments like theirs that actually have spoiled the lake.
Munche adnai yo nan ishtu udugana bandu mele illi aita ee kara ಆವಾಗಿಂದ ಹಸುಗಳ ಮೇವರೆಲ್ಲ ಮೇಯ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬರ್ತದೆ ಎಲ್ಲವರು ಹಸು ಬರ್ತದೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಕಡೆ ಹಸು ಬೆಳ್ಳಂಡ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಹಸು ಕೈಕೊಂಡ್ರೆಲ್ಲ ಹಸು ಎಲ್ಲ ಈ ಕಾಯಕ ಬದುವುದು ನೆಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಆಯಿಂಟ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಯಾವುದು ಬರೋದಿಲ್ಲ
ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಹುಟ್ಟು ಬೆಳೆದಿರೋದು ಆವತ್ತಿನಿಂದ ನಮ್ಮ ತಾತನವ್ರ ಕಾಲದಿಂದ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹುಟ್ಟು ಬೆಳೆದಿದ್ದು ಇದು ಎಲ್ಲ ಈ ಕೆರೆ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ನಮ್ಮೂರ ಕೆರೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ
Most of the lakes in Bangalore have a school somewhere in the surroundings. And that's just the way they were set up, because they had some government land or some patch of land along the lakeside. And so if you look at the school, for instance, these kids, the way they know biodiversity, the way they know the trees, the way they know the lake, the opportunity this lake gives for urban education for a school that's right there. I still remember, I mean, we were doing a bird walk around the lake and we saw this Brahmini kite swoop into the water, pick up a snake, take it wriggling in its beak and go off to the island to have its feast undisturbed. It was such a thrilling sight. I mean, it's one of those things you just cannot forget. And to think in the heart of the city, surrounded by all these apartments, surrounded by this noise and this chaos, you can have that feeling that you've seen nature. A lake of this size, you know, close to 45 acres, revived, thriving, more than 100 species of birds, all kinds of snakes and amphibians and insects that we don't even know about in this lake. I think it's beautiful. Pelicans have come back, which we are, you know, weren't there for at least a decade before. The groundwater levels in this area, just around the lake, have increased. And fresh air, you know, cooling the city, urban heat island effects. If you look at flooding, I think the flooding in this area would have been much worse last monsoon when it was very heavy, if it wasn't for this lake and this entire chain of lakes that have been revived in this area. They've been cleaned up. The lakes and their wetlands have been restored. And therefore, these lakes can hold a lot of water. The stormwater drains and the functional network and the lakes and the wetlands, which can take the water, hold it and percolate it down into the soil. So not only did our groundwater increase, a lot of the areas, surrounding areas, were spared the devastation that comes with intense flooding. There's so much that this lake is doing for this neighborhood. So I'm hopeful still that, you know, if number of groups start doing this and people can see that this is a different way to work towards lake conservation, that we'll get there. Well, there are a number of learnings I think one could take away from Kaikondrelli Lake. So let's start breaking that up. One of the first would be just in terms of having a physical learning space. I think many lake communities, when they come in, they want to start rejuvenation. This is a knowledge hub. You don't know whom to contact, where to get the papers from, who is the government agency in charge of managing your lake, how do you come up with a plan, what is a detailed project report, how do they call for bids, you know, all of these little technical things that we were clueless about. Now the trust serves as a knowledge hub. The second one is how to get people together. I think over time one learns that a place like this can be such a valuable learning resource. So the groups that have met here are now doing things like solid waste management, working with government schools, working on nutrition issues, working on road traffic, working on making areas pedestrian friendly, looking at air pollution issues, looking at citizen monitoring of water. You know, the number of diverse things that are spread out from having one community place. And I think the third thing is the fact that in a city, you can't work without people and you can't work without the state.
When we're talking about being inclusive, it is the municipal bodies, the politicians, the local people who live around here, you know, whether recreational, livelihood, whatever other uses, it's everybody. Because we can't and we should not take the approach that, oh, the government is corrupt, so we shouldn't do anything with them, because then that doesn't lead us anywhere. And it's not true for a lot of the government officials as well. Or the government cannot look at us and say, oh, these are apathetic people, they won't do anything, so we can do what we want, because that is not true as well. And I think that attitude, we need to change, they need to change, everybody needs to change around to see if we can all work together to make something better.